friends, my name is Krishna Rashid. I am from Annara. So last class we are discussing about a topic from 8th standard, that is mensuration. In mensuration we already discussed about areas and perimeters of some closed figures, and already we discussed about areas of trapeziums. So let us move to the next topic, that is area of general quadrilateral. Area of general quadrilateral. Yes, so area of general quadrilateral, already you know about quadrilaterals, the figure having four sides, four vertices and four angles. So we already learnt about the quadrilateral, it's also a closed figure and occupying some area made up of line segments. Already we learnt about those things. So let us take the area of general quadrilateral. Here we have to find out the area of the general quadrilateral. So in a quadrilateral, so using the known things, we have to find out the formula for finding area of the general quadrilateral. So let us take one quadrilateral here. So you can take any quadrilateral. Here I am taking this quadrilateral here. Yes, so here we have one quadrilateral, that is ABCD. ABCD is a quadrilateral. So here we have to find out the formula for finding the area of the general quadrilateral. So we want a formula, so from the given things. So here ABCD is a quadrilateral. Consider ABCD is a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral. Yes. So we already learnt about the properties and the characteristics of the quadrilateral. The quadrilateral has four vertices, that is A, B, C, D, and four sides A, B, B, C, C, D, and A, D, and four angles. So here angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. And also we can draw two diagonals. That is, so the line segment connecting to two non-consecutive vertices. So here firstly I will construct a diameter, one diameter, at least one diameter we have to take here. I will draw AC. Here I will draw AC diameter. Yes. So here it is a given thing, it is ABCD is a quadrilateral. So given. So here we have to construct. Construction. What is the construction here? Draw AC diagonal. Draw AC diagonal. Yes. So here just observe the diagonal. The diagonal splits entire this quadrilateral into two separate triangles. That means, so when we have to find out the area of this quadrilateral, so we can add the area of these two circles, these two triangles. So here, from the diagonal, the whole quadrilateral splits into two separate triangles. So we have to find out the area of the quadrilateral means. So simply we can add this area of this triangle and this triangle. It is enough. So that means here just observe, when we have to find out the area of the triangle, already we know that the area of the triangle is equal to half into base into height. Here base is common. So base is common for these two triangles, then we have to take the perpendicular height. So here I will take the perpendicular height here. Yes, here I have the perpendicular height with the base, and here I have the perpendicular height with the base. Yes. So I will name it as H1 and H2. Here it is H1. I will take this as H2. So and AC is the common base for these two triangles. Then, so let us take the proof. So here we have to find out the formula for finding the area of the general quadrilateral. Yes. So then, consider this area of the quadrilateral. The area of the quadrilateral is equal to sum of area of this triangle ABC and triangle ADC. That is, diagonal splits the quadrilateral into two separate triangles, that is triangle ABC and triangle ADC. Then the area of the quadrilateral will be the sum of the areas of these two triangles, that is area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ADC. So the sum of areas of these two triangles. So let us take that one. So already we know that the area of triangle is equal to half into base into height. So according to that one, we have to find out the formula. That is half into, yes, what is the base here? So base is AC. AC half into base in the end. Height it is from triangle ABC, H2 is the height. H2 plus. And here, area. So area of triangle ADC, that is half into base. What is the base of this triangle ADC? That is AC. And height it is H1 is equal to. So here already we know that AC is a diagonal. So that's why we can take AC as a D, that is diameter. That is half into, so D into H2 plus 1 by 2 into, here also AC we have, AC is the diagonal, that is D into H1. So we can take out half into D from these two terms. So here 1 by 2 into D, so what remains here? H2 plus here H1 remains is equal to 1 by 2 into D into H1 plus H2 is the area of the quadrilateral, that is area of the quadrilateral is equal to half into D into H1 plus H2. How it? So here area of the triangle, here we have to write the reason. Area of triangle is equal to half into base into height. So here we have to write the reason for that one. Here we substituted the area of the triangle formula here. And here just observe, because AC is equal to D, that is diameter here. So H1 and H2 are the height. H1 is the height of the triangle ADC and H2 is the height of the triangle ABC. That is H1 is the height of triangle ADC and H2 is the height of triangle ABC. Yes. So here we have the area of the quadrilateral formula. Using this formula, so we have to find out the area of the given quadrilateral. That is, area of the quadrilateral is equal to half into diameter into H1 plus H2. So we can take H1 and H2, whatever it may be. So don't stick with anyone. So here ADC in ABC, here this quadrilateral, from this quadrilateral here ABCD, the diameter splits into two separate triangles, that is ABC and ADC. Yes. So I hope you understood this thing. So let us take some of the problems. Let us take the first problem of this video here. So here just observe. So we have a quadrilateral PQRS and the values of height it is given and the base it is given here. So using those things we have to find out the area of this quadrilateral. So from the diagonal, that is the diagonal QS divides this complete PQRS quadrilateral into two separate triangles, that is PQS and QRS. So here it is given, the height of this triangle QRS is given and the height of the triangle PQS it is given, and the base is also given. It's 5.5 cm. Height of the PQS triangle it is 1.5 cm and height of the Triangle QRS is 2.5 cm. Using the given things, we have to find out the area of this quadrilateral PQRS. So, firstly, we have to write the given things. It is given. Given is, so firstly, H1. So, I will take H1 is equal to 2.5 cm. And H2 is equal to, that is 1.5 cm. And the base it is given, that is diameter. It's actually a diameter. When we consider the triangles, means it's a base. That is D is equal to 5.5 cm. All the things, all the given values are in centimeter. That's why no need to change any values. So, let us take the formula of finding area of the quadrilateral and then we have to substitute the values. That is, area of the quadrilateral is equal to 1 by 2 into D into H1 plus H2. So here we know the value of D, H1 and H2. So just substitute it here. So 1 by 2 into, what's the value of D? It is 5.5 cm and then value of H1, it is 2.5 cm. 2.5 plus, and H2 it is 1.5 cm, it is 1.5 is equal to 1 by 2 into 5.5 I mean as it is, and here just observe 2.5 plus 1, 3.5, 0.5 means it is 4. So 2 into 1 and 2 into 2, here we have 5.5 into 2, so 5 into 2 means it is 10. So here 0.5 we have, 0.5 also we have to add twice, so that's why 5.5 into 2, it is 11 centimeter square is the area of this quadrilateral PQRS. So just substitute the value and get the answer. So it is the easiness of mathematics, that is, when we have the formula, when we have the values, just substitute it and get the value. So it is easy to us, that is, area of this quadrilateral, area of quadrilateral PQRS is equal to 11 centimeter square we have to take, it's a area. So let us take some of the homework. Let us take one homework here. So here just observe, we have a quadrilateral, it's a diagonal of a quadrilateral shape, field is 24 meter, that is diagonal it is given. So QS is diagonal, that is 24 meter it is given, and the perpendicular dropped on it from the remaining opposite vertices. That means here just observe. So from two vertices. So here from two non-consecutive vertices we draw a diameter here. That is QS. So remaining two opposite vertices means it is R and the P. So these two are the remaining opposite vertices. And perpendicular dropped on it. So that means on the diameter a perpendicular it is drawn from the remaining opposite vertices, that is, it is given, one is 8 meter and one is 13 meter. Here it is 8 meter and here it is 13 meter, whatever you can take here. There is no any given, it is here only you have to take, no. But the concept it is, one is 8 meter and another one is 13 meter. And find the area of the field, that means using this one we have to find the area of this quadrilateral shaped field. So I hope you understood these things. Using the formula we can find out the area of this field. So those who are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. You can get the notification of our channel very easily. Also hit the like button. Thank you on it all. Be safe and stay home. Thank you.